Hi everyone. So today we are going to deal with the LPG policy. In the previous class, we have talked about the characteristics and unique trends of Indian economy. So this is the chapter name. We are dealing with chapter 15. There we have seen about Indian economy as an underdeveloped economy and as a developing economy. We looked at various factors like per capita income, national income, standard of living, healthcare and educational facilities, unemployment, poverty, agricultural growth, etc. In this video, we are going to look at the next part of this chapter, which talks about the reforms which took place in the Indian economy during 1990. Now, those reforms are known as LPG, or liberalization, privatization and globalization. Now, these reforms were done in the year 1990s. So, also known as 1991 reform, these were done in the year 1991. Now, this was because of the BOP crisis, which happened in 1990s onward. So, from 1990s onward, there was a BOP crisis, which is balance of payment crisis, and this led to India going for the 1991 reforms. So, what are these 1991 reforms? These are the liberalization, privatization and globalization. Now, these reforms opened the Indian economy to the foreign investors. But prior to 1991, Indian economy was a closed economy. Not completely closed, partially closed economy. Foreign trade was under strict control. So, what were the situations which led to adoption of LPG policy? So, aisa kya economy mein hua ki Bharat Sarkar ko LPG policy adopt karni padi? So, hum un wajah ko janenge. We will look at those things like why LPG policy was adopted. So, let us go back to the Indian economy. Let's see what were the problems existed prior to 1990. So, a number of problems were there. One was higher expenses of the government on defense and social sector. Social sector matlab aapke roadways, railways, highways, industries ho gai, education, healthcare services, public transportation, etc. So government ka jo expenditure tha, it was high on defense and social sector services. Now this led to lesser revenue available to the government to spend on capital industry. So jitna government ke paas revenue tha, usme majority jo tha, वो कहाँ पर खर्च हो जाता था, वो डिफेंस एंड सोशल सेक्टर्स में स्पेंड हो जाता था, तो हायर एक्सपेंडिचर था, तो गवर्नमेंट के पास बहुत कम रेवेन्यू बचता था जिसे वो इंडस्ट्रीज में इन्वेस्ट कर सके. सो इसके चक्कर में जो हमारी इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ थी, दैट वॉज लो. सो दिस लेड टू स्लो इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ. ठीक है. नाउ सेकेंड थिंग थी lack of fiscal discipline. Fiscal discipline, I'll tell you, fiscal discipline means when government forms its policies in such a way that its deficits are reduced. Deficit matlab aapki jo debt hoti hai wo kam ho jaye. So agar hum fiscal deficit ki definition ki baat kare, main yahan likh leta hu aapke liye. ये बुक में भी ये डेफिनेशन अवेलेबल है. सो फिस्कल डेफिशिट है, फिस्कल डिसिप्लिन है, पॉलिसीज मेड बाय गवर्नमेंट. टू लेसन और टू रिड्यूस द बर्डन ऑफ डेफिशिट. डेफिशिट मतलब उधारी. सो मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम जब गवर्नमेंट के पास पैसा नहीं होता, गवर्नमेंट मार्केट से लोन लेता है. सो फिस्कल डिसिप्लिन मतलब आप अपनी पॉलिसीज को उस वे में क्रिएट करो, उस वे में इम्प्लीमेंट करो कि आपका जो डेफिसिट है वो रिड्यूस हो जाए. नाउ फिस्कल डेफिसिट वॉज देयर. सो देयर वॉज लैक ऑफ फिस्कल डिसिप्लिन. लैक ऑफ फिस्कल डिसिप्लिन इम्प्लाइड दैट government was borrowing more and more, more from market, but was not able to expend, was not able to gather the enough revenue. मतलब expenditure तो काफी ज़्यादा था, but उतना revenue नहीं आ पा रहा था. उस चक्कर में lack of fiscal discipline was there in the economy. So one was lack of fiscal discipline. तीसरा जो reason है वो था trade deficit. अब trade deficit international economics का है. Trade deficit आता है जब आप ट्रेड करते हैं, इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड, जब दो कंट्री आपस में ट्रेड करती है, वी कॉल दैट पर्टिकुलर ट्रेड एज ट्रेड डेफिशिट, इन द सेंस दैट आपके इंपोर्ट्स और एक्सपोर्ट डिटरमाइन करते हैं आपके पास ट्रेड डेफिशिट है या ट्रेड सरप्लस है. सो जैसे इंडिया और यूएस ट्रेड कर रहे हैं तो उस ट्रेड को हम बोलेंगे इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड. नाउ व्हेन ट्रेड टेक्स प्लेस, व्हाट इज द आउटकम ऑफ द ट्रेड, वेदर द कंट्री इज बेनिफिटिंग और नॉट, वी कैलकुलेट इट थ्रू ट्रेड डेफिशिट. सो ट्रेड डेफिशिट इज access of country's import upon its export, meaning that your imports are greater than your exports. Import मतलब आप उस country से सामान ज़्यादा खरीद रहे हो और जो दूसरी country है वो आपसे कम सामान खरीद रही है. So जब आपके imports ज़्यादा होते हैं export से, तब आपको आपकी जो foreign currency होती है वो कम हो जाती है, क्योंकि आपको ज़्यादा पैसा देना पड़ता है to the other country so that you can import the goods. So trade deficit was also increasing and it was high. So what import upon export मतलब जो आपकी import है, import यानी you are purchasing goods and services from the other country. Example India and US का हम देखते हैं international trade. Suppose India and US trade कर रहे हैं, जो India है वो US से ज़्यादा goods खरीद रहे हैं, तो उससे क्या बोलेंगे हम, import. अब India के केस में imports ज़्यादा हैं 1990s के पहले, और exports मतलब जो US है वो इंडिया से ज़्यादा सामान खरीद रहा है. एक्सपोर्ट मतलब हम सामने वाली कंट्री को ज़्यादा सामान दे रहे हैं. सो बिकॉज हमारे एक्सपोर्ट्स कम थे, बिकॉज आर इम्पोर्ट्स फॉर मोर एक्सपोर्ट्स फॉर लेस, देयर वॉज ट्रेड डेफिशिट. सो ट्रेड डेफिशिट की डेफिनेशन इज एक्सेस ऑफ कंट्रीज इम्पोर्ट्स अपॉन इट्स एक्सपोर्ट. थर्ड रीजन, फोर्थ रीजन था स्लो स्पीड ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, एक्सेसिव पब्लिक स्पेंडिंग, हाई इन्फ्लेशन. नाउ प्रोडक्शन जो इंडस्ट्रीज थी उनमें मॉडर्न टेक्नोलॉजीज नहीं थी, बिकॉज ऑफ लैक ऑफ मॉडर्न टेक्नोलॉजी द प्रोडक्शन वॉज लो, प्रोडक्टिविटी वॉज लो, एफिशियंसी वॉज लो, एंड हायर पब्लिक स्पेंडिंग वॉज देयर, एंड हाई इन्फ्लेशन वॉज ऑल्सो देयर बिकॉज प्रोडक्शन वॉज लेस बट द मनी विच वॉज स्पेंड बाई गवर्नमेंट वॉज हाई. सो एक्सेसिव गवर्नमेंट स्पेंडिंग वॉज देयर बट लो प्रोडक्शन वॉज देयर, which led to rising inflation. Now this led to slow growth of economy. The fifth problem is about balance of payment. Balance of payment, what it is balance of payment, I'll write it. Fiscal discipline ka please likh dijiyega. And please maintain a separate copy for make two copies, one for history geography and another for economics and civics. Okay, so talking about the balance of payment, so what is balance of payment? It is a systematic record of all the transaction of a country with the rest of the world. So transaction of country with rest of the world are recorded in balance of payment. All the transaction of a country with rest of the world. Now आपको एक चीज ध्यान रखनी है, जो balance of payment है, from balance of payment we come to know about trade deficit. So trade deficit balance of payment का part है, क्योंकि balance of payment से हमें पता चल जाता है what is the trade deficit. Now this is about balance of payment. Now there was a BOP crisis, BOP yeah, or balance of payment. Now because of the balance of payment crisis, India was in a position to implement such reforms. because of BOP crisis, low economic growth, high inflation, high public spending, higher trade deficit, lack of fiscal discipline, higher expenses of government on defense and social sector led to, and it created such problems in the economy wherein government was forced to implement the LPG policy. Now, when LPG policy was implemented, now this happened because of the conditions which were put forth by two international organizations. One was IMF and World Bank. So, ye to hogi prior to 1990 situation. Because of this situation, we implemented these reforms. So, as I have mentioned that India took loan from World Bank and IMF. When India took loan from World Bank and IMF, it was forced to implement such policy. So, World Bank and IMF told that India should liberalize the economy, should privatize and should globalize. So, when you liberalize, privatize and globalize your economic growth will be there and then only you will get loan. So, this was the condition for the loan and India implemented that and got the loan and got loan from World Bank and IMF. Now, so what is liberalization, privatization and globalization? We'll see. So, liberalization. First is liberalization. So, what is liberalization? So, liberalization means when you are easing the rules and regulation. Liberalization means when you are liberalizing your policy so that a foreign country can invest in your economy. So, foreign companies can come. So, liberalization is easing of rules and regulation for the investment for the investment. So in liberalization, the policies, rules are made investor friendly. Are made investor friendly. So, liberalization means when you are allowing the foreign country to invest in your economy. So, liberalization ka direct impact here. The foreign companies they came and invested in India. So, that is known as liberalization or liberalizing your economy wherein you are easing your rules and regulation so that foreign country can come and invest in your economy. Thus, liberalization led to massive investment flowing into the three sectors of the economy, which is primary, secondary and tertiary, into these sectors of economy. And so because of liberalization, many foreign companies invested in India. New investment came . So this is liberalization. Now comes privatization. So what is privatization? We will see about privatization. So second is about privatization. Privatization means when you are opening or when you are allowing, so when you allow private sector to invest in various industries. So prior to 1990 se pehle certain industries were there jahan par private investment was not allowed. Because of that only government industries were there. But after 1990, through privatization, foreign companies and the private sector was allowed to invest in various industries. Example, automobile. So jo car making industries hai usme foreign investment was allowed, private sector was allowed to set up their industry. Okay, so private sector was allowed to come and invest. So privatization, second component of privatization is when you are disinvesting or disinvestment of public sector units or public sector companies. Public sector companies means those companies of government which are owned and controlled by government. So disinvestment of public sector units. So through disinvestment, what happens? Disinvestment means selling a portion of company, portion of share of company. So half of the company's share, or based on the government need, some portion of company's share is sold to a private sector. So private sector investment is allowed in the government units. So this is about privatization, when you allow private investor to come and invest, certain industries are relaxed. This also involves de-licensing. So what is de-licensing? De-licensing means you don't require a license to set up industry. So certain industry licensing, license Raj permit was ended, and so de-licensing was adopted, and license was not required to set up an industry in various areas. So privatization was done. So one was liberalization, second is privatization. Now third is globalization. So you understood the privatization. Now the concept of globalization. So what is globalization? Globalization means it basically means when you are integrating your domestic economy with the economy of the rest of the world. Globalization implies integration of domestic economy with the economy of rest of the world or with the other countries. So in globalization, what happened is a particular company operates in more than two countries. So here comes the concept of MNC or multinational corporation. So what is an MNC? So MNC is a unit, it is a company which owns and controls production in more than two countries. So typical MNC involves procuring raw material. So MNC mein jo raw material hota hai, they procure raw material from one country. Suppose they procured raw material from India. Okay, Then production takes place in China. Production कहाँ हो रहा है? China में. और goods sold कहाँ हो रहे हैं? And selling of goods in USA. So this is about globalization, wherein a raw material is procured from one country, it is produced in another country, it is sold in another country. So this is the concept of globalization, where a country, a company in a country operates in more than two countries. So in globalization, you are opening your economy, so the domestic producer can now sell their product in foreign company. So in easy way, globalization implies that a seller in India or a company in India can sell the goods to the customer, can sell the goods to the customer in other countries. So this is the concept of globalization. So India adopted the LPG policy in 1991, and these were the reforms, or as said about the meaning of liberalization, privatization, globalization. So these were the reforms which government made. And because of such reforms, the Indian economy grew at a rate of 8%, and we have seen that the national income and per capita income, both of them were increasing. So all of them happened because of the LPG reforms which we took. Now, with respect to globalization, the trade which takes place, when the international trade takes place, we discussed about trade deficit and the balance of payment. Now, when the trade takes place, the World Trade Organization is the premier organization. It sees the international trade. So it overlooks at the international trade. So a quick fact for you. If you get anything in exam about World Trade Organization, you should know these things. That World Trade Organization was formed in 1995. Okay, so in 1995, World Trade Organization came. Before 1995, it was known as GATT, which is General Agreement on Trade and Tariff. So 1995 ke baad WTO ka gaya. So it is often said that World Trade Organization came into force in 1995, or it was formed in 1995. So what does WTO do? One is, implementing multilateral trade agreement resolving disputes . Okay, so other more functions are there. So this is about WTO. If you get any question, you can write this answer. Now talking about the concept of Swadeshi. So what is Swadeshi? You might have read in the history about Swadeshi movement, which was started by Mahatma Gandhi, where we have seen that British goods were boycotted and Indian goods were purchased. So in order to, you know, for the vision of self-reliance, etc., and to support the domestic industry. In modern world, it is very difficult to go for Swadeshi, because economies have been integrated through LPG policy. Now, because of LPG, Indian economy is integrated with the rest of the world. So, agar ek particular country mein kuch economic problem hoti hai, to uska direct impact India pe bhi aata hai. Because of LPG policy, because of globalization, when your economy is integrated. So prior to LPG, Indian economy was here, US economy was here. After globalization, they came in same circle. So they got integrated. So whatever problem happened in one part of the world, the other country gets affected. So talking about Swadeshi, so LPG reforms are done. Now we will look at the concept of Swadeshi. So Swadeshi means buying goods manufactured by domestic industry. एग्जाम्पल अगर हम देखते हैं, जस्ट थिंक ऑफ एग्जाम्पल, कौन कौन सी कंट्रीज जो इंडिया की है, कंपनीज इंडिया की है, कौन सी इंडिया की कंपनीज है जो गुड्स प्रोड्यूस करती है, इंडिजीनियस प्रोडक्शन. आपके पास एग्जाम्पल में क्या क्या आ गया, टाटा, अमूल, फिर आपका गोदरेज. सो नंबर ऑफ कंपनीज आर देयर विच प्रोड्यूस गुड्स इन इंडिया. So the and these are Indian companies. Okay. So Swadeshi means buying goods manufactured by domestic industries. Okay. So when we go for Swadeshi, what happens? The economic growth increases. So the impact of Swadeshi is first is creates employment opportunities. Okay. Second is reduce poverty. Third is increases or increase in economic growth. And many more impact are there. So when Swadeshi simply means when you buy goods which are made by Indian companies like Tata, Amul, Godrej, etc. Number of Indian companies are there. So when you purchase goods manufactured by these countries, when these companies, you call it as a Swadeshi. Because Swadeshi means buying goods manufactured by Indian companies. Now the impact of Swadeshi is when you buy goods which are manufactured by the Indian companies, the impact is it creates more employment opportunities, because when you buy more and more goods, the demand will also increase. When demand will increase, production will increase, and this will create employment opportunities. Second is about reduce poverty. When employment will increase, poverty will decrease, because people will get jobs, they will have income, they will come out of poverty trap. Third is increase in economic growth. When growth of domestic industry increases, when the growth increases, the economic growth also increases, because these industries contribute to the Indian economy. Because they are part of Indian economy, their growth will definitely reflect in the growth of GDP. So when we sum up with respect to important benefits of Swadeshi, when we look at some of the important benefits of Swadeshi, these three we have covered: reduce poverty. So benefits of Swadeshi. One is demand for goods reduced by Indian industries will increase. Second will be national income will increase. The third will be the imports will decline, because the good which we are importing will now be produced in our economy only. So imports will decline. This will lead to low trade deficit, will make India self-dependent etc. So when we look at all these benefits, we come to know that it will make India self-dependent, it will reduce poverty, it will increase employment opportunities etc. In the book 10-12 points are there regarding the benefits of Swadeshi. Please write it down in your notebook. It is very, very important, and remember it. The last topic is about skill development. Now coming to the last topic, small topic, which is about skill development. So what is skill development? Skill development is when you increase the skill of the human resource. Increasing the skill of the human capital. Human capital is the labor. So what is human capital? It is the labor. So it is labor which is skilled, okay. So when you increase the skill of a human capital, so when you provide a labor with training so that he can get certain skill, we call it as skill development. In India, the government launched skill development mission, okay. So the government launched National Skill Development Mission. Okay, and this mission led to, in under this mission, skilling is done. So if a person wants to acquire certain skill, a person is given training so that he can get certain skills. Reskilling is also done. So through skill development mission, the efficiency and productivity is increased. And this mission was launched in the year 2015. So this is about the small topic, and in the next video we are going to solve the question answers, and we will about these on both the chapters which we have covered, the chapter 14 and chapter 15. Thank you.